Now, let's see how to apply this. Here we have a case, a straight line L, this is the line L, say, is perpendicular to the line 2x plus y minus 6 is 0 and cuts the x-axis at the cuts the x-axis at 3 comma 0. So this is cutting it, say, at x-axis at 3 comma 0, and there is a line, it is perpendicular to this line, and it, say, cuts. So suppose you have, let's take it this way, you have this line over here, and there is a line 2x plus 3y, like this, say, and there is a line which is perpendicular to this line, say this one, this is line L, and it is perpendicular to this line, and it cuts the x-axis at 3, 0. Find the distance from the point 2, minus 3 to the line L. So, there is a point 2, minus 3, and there is a line 2x plus y minus 6 is equal to 0. Now here, if you see this particular 2x plus y minus 6 is 0. So this is x1, this is y1, this is a, this is b, this is c. So it is going to be the distance d is given by a into x1, that is absolute value of 2 into 2 plus b, that is 1 into minus 3 plus c, minus 6, divided by a square plus b square, that is a square is 2 square plus b square 1 square, which will turn out to be 4 minus 3 minus 6 upon 2 square plus 1 square is root 5. This will turn out to be 4 minus 9 minus 5 upon root 5 absolute value, which is nothing but 5 upon root 5. If you rationalize the denominator, you can multiply both numerator and denominator by root 5. You're multiplying this by root 5, root 5 into root 5 is 5, and it gets cancelled, and you get root 5 as the distance. So, over here, it's slightly deceptive kind of a question, because some information over here is not needed. Cuts the x-axis at 3, 0 is not featuring anywhere. Some point minus 2 comma 3 you have, and that point possibly lies on this line, and that point's distance from here. So this is just to, since it's perpendicular, and the point 2 comma minus 3 is over here, somewhere over here, 2 comma minus 3 may be somewhere down here, and that will tell. So this 3 comma 0 is redundant information, not needed. You just have to read the question. It's told find the distance from the point 2 comma minus 3 to the line L. So hence we have it like that. So among these, the option is root 5. And yes, we do have it as root 5. Now furthermore, let's see what we have. Okay. Now, it's told, if the point k, 3 is at a distance of root 5 units from the point 2, k, the value of k is so and so. So the point k, 3, now k, 3 is x1, y1, is at the distance of root 5 from the point 2, 3, and x2, y2 is 2, k, which means that distance between the points, it is y2 minus y1 the whole square plus x2 minus x1 the whole square. This one square root is root 5, which means that if you square it, you get 5. Now y2 minus y1 is k minus 3 the whole square plus y2 minus 2 minus k the whole square is equal to 5. So that gives you k square minus 6x plus 9 plus 4 minus 4k plus k square minus 5 is 0. So this gives you k square plus k square, 2k square minus 6k, I'm sorry, minus 6k minus 4k minus 10k, 9 plus 4, 13, 13 minus 5 is 8, sorry, plus 8, divide by 2, you get k square minus 5k plus 4 is 0. So this is what you get. Now if you split up the middle term, you will end up and solve this, you will end up getting k is 4 and k is 1. So hence, in such a case, the distance between the points, if it is root 5, k can attain two values. You can see, for example, 4 minus 3, the whole square is 1 square, and 2 minus 4 minus 3, the 1, so you can take k could be either 1 or k could be odd. K could be 4. So either ways you get it as, for example, if you take k as 4, you get this will become 1 and this will become 4, and hence square root of that is root 5. The other way around, we get this is f4 and this is 1. Okay, so our option is going to be 1 and 4 both, and yes, we do have it right.